have a link. Do you know when they put it on the webpage and a link to go to Rotary?
Everybody, First Sergeant! First Sergeant!
No, stay!
Thank you, First Sergeant!
Welcome!
And we marched to a small farm community in the Pennsylvania called Gettysburg. And there on the hot afternoon of July 2nd, 1863, the 104 men of the 9th Massachusetts Light Artillery saw combat for the very first time. There was only one man in that battery that had seen combat. That was Captain John Bigelow, who I portray. He had been wounded at the Battle of Antietam.
This is the curved knife using the circular cut method of amputation. This has been around since Galen in Roman times. It is efficient. And it works, but I do not prefer it. I prefer the flap method, for which I would need a double scalpel, which the captain's supposed to requisition for me. But this is what I have, so this is what I'll use. So you cut all the way down to the flesh to the bone. Then you...
Prepare to fire! Fire!
Whoa.
This is a comfort style pen. It's called comfort style because of the little bump it has on the end. It's easy to hold, comfortable to write with. And it starts off as a block and it gets spun on a lathe. And then it gets shaved off with a gouge. And the final product is this right here. It's a twist pen. You can refill it.
What do you got? You got candy and one.
You can write with it as much as you want. And that's about it.
Thank you.
same. Well, we hurt each other, better do it again.
Bit of early town history, because an old burying ground is centered, this old burying ground in particular, is centered around the history of the early history of the town. Many of the names you will find in here you will recognize as early settlers of the town. Most of them have streets named after them in town. The town was originally settled. Thank you for coming.
Okay.
We're here to honor Lieutenant Howard Burnham, whose grave is right here. And we are the reenactors of the 9th Massachusetts Light Artillery, and Howard Burnham was an artillerist. Howard was born here in LongMeddowe on March 17th in 1842. When there are a lot of accounts of Howard's youth, he would march up and down the town common. Remembered by his pastor, he would lead the other kids with a toy drum, and he was playing, he was in charge. So he had, very early on, some signs of leadership. When Howard was in his late teens, he had a premonition that was in the late 1850s that something was going to happen on a national basis. The politics of the day, the talk of secession. Howard's battery went into action on September 17th, and it was a horrific battle, and his guns were eventually overrun by the Confederate soldiers, Wall Falls, Mississippians. They actually came across the field and captured and were right on top of Howard's guns. And Howard Burnham's battery had no support whatsoever. So his five guns were overrun. The Confederates were right up on them firing. And Howard Burnham did not run. He didn't shirk. He didn't skedaddle and try to save his own life. He stood right on his ground, right over his guns, and he sustained a mortal wound to the chest. And he died over his guns. He lingered for about a funeral here in town. And there were accounts of the funeral in the local newspapers. And Howard is now interred right here. And after, if you look at his grave, you'll see the cannon over his grave and the sword. That's the grave of an artillerist. And the graves here at the end, you have Howard's grandparents, and you have Howard's parents, and then Howard's sister, and then you have Howard. And this grave right here is of three infants. Two were born to Howard's parents and died very early on. And the third baby that was in there was born to Howard's grandparents. So there are three of the Burnhams buried in this last grave here, the one on my far left. So we're going to do a salute to Howard Burnham now and honor him, a very brave artillerist and a real hero from LongMeddowe. Lieutenant?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Rifle squad, attention! Rifle squad, fire!
Thank you all for coming.
This concludes
our portion of the tour. Thank you all.
Again, thank you very much for coming, and join us on this Memorial Day service. This is our 138th anniversary, and I would say that we're committed to forever continuing the service of gratitude to all those who died for the collective freedom that we enjoy.
Fire.
Present arm.
Welcome to the Storrs House. This is the home of the LongMeddowe Historical Society and Archives. This house was built in 1786 by the second minister. He came to LongMeddowe. He was actually a cousin of the first minister. First minister being Stephen Williams. And this fellow here is Richard Salter Storrs. And that's his first wife. The other paintings in this room are his son, also named Richard Salter Storrs, a minister as well, and his son on the far wall is another Richard Salter Storrs, who was a minister in Brooklyn. It's interesting in families in those days, nowadays we use junior and senior when people have the same names, or first, second, third, but then they did not. And he had several sons. The first son, he did name Richard Salter Storrs. The next sons had other names, but then they named their son Richard Salter Storrs. So at one time, there were about six different guys living with the same name, Richard Salter Storrs. We regret that he did not keep a diary. However, the minister before him kept a diary for the 67 years that he, Stephen Williams, was the minister in LongMeddowe. That diary is pre-revolution, and it's an everyday diary. So it is treasured by scholars because it's what everyday life was like in the colonial period, at least from the early 1700s right up to the revolution. We're almost a month away from LongMeddowe Days this year, 2011. We're hoping that we have excellent weather. When we look at how many times we've had LongMeddowe Days, we've had good weather, most. Come anyway, rain or shine, we'll have all the exciting things that everyone looks forward to, crafters, great food, good music, lots of historical elements, a visit here to the Storrs House. LongMeddowe Days is the main fundraiser for the LongMeddowe Historical Society and this museum, where you can learn about LongMeddowe history in a tour. You can come and do research on families that you could be descended from. We have many family artifacts, journals, diaries, old photographs of what LongMeddowe did look like. LongMeddowe Days this year will have some new elements to it. We do now bring some of our museum pieces to the green so that people can see a sample of some of the wonderful things from olden days that we have here in our museum. We hope to gain new members because certainly a historical society thrives on a strong membership who not only attend LongMeddowe Days to make that a success, but attend some of our other events that we hold throughout the year. That's how we maintain this 200-year-old museum. So I hope to see you at LongMeddowe Days. I hope you come and visit us at the Storrs House, and certainly visit us at our booth on the green.